Hello friends and ladies in particular. Today's topic is interesting. Homeopathic treatment for uterine fibroids. Do you know that out of 100 hysterectomies which ladies undergo for whatever reasons, one third the reason for hysterectomy is a fibroid uterus. What is fibroid? It's a growth. Is it cancerous? No, it's a benign growth. It can occur in any age of a lady, but of course in the reproductive age it occurs and gradually it goes down. But one third cause of hysterectomy is alarming. So do all fibroids require surgery? Well, we'll discuss it today. Can homeopathy offer a good amount of relief to some types of fibroids? Well, we'll answer it today. But to take the whole thing ahead, first we'll try to understand what are fibroids? How do they occur? What is the reason? In which ladies, of which part of the world, of which particular age the fibroid is more? Is it an infection? Is there other hormonal reason for the fibroids? Well, I'll request my colleague, my student, Dr. Manisha Parekh to talk on this for a couple of minutes. It's good to encourage students because they also, you know, while talking, the way we started talking and then could address a bigger amount of people. May I request Manisha to come here.
Arik here to explain you the causes of fibroid. Fibroid is a common benign tumor in the uterus. The simple causes for it could be, first, it's a positive tendency of family to have fibroids. Secondly, it could be chromosomal variations, like the chromosomal variation in 6 or 7. Then there could be malignant changes, which could be cancerous or benign. Then there could be changes in the any of the somatic cells which can cause fibroids. Hormonal imbalances, especially estrogen, progesterone. These both hormones are responsible to make the lining of the uterus during the menstrual cycle, and these can cause the growth of fibroids. Secondly, there could be imbalances in the formation of the blood vascular system, which can cause fibroids. It is not seen in girls who have not reached the age of puberty. Usually, fibroids grow slowly. They take 3 to 5 years to grow to a size which could be felt sufficiently on per abdomen examination. But when females are pregnant, it rather causes higher increase, and hence people who are also taking pills, high dosage pills, have more tendency to get fibroids. People who are nulliparous, obese, hyperestrogenic states, black women are more likely to get fibroids. So I would like to end my discussion over here. I hope I have really explained you well. And now I call upon my colleague, Dr. Shreyas, to speak about the signs and symptoms.
Everybody, I am Shreyas Panchar and a medical student. Today's topic being uterine fibroids. As my friend Manisha has already explained what are uterine fibroids are. Now I will proceed with its signs and symptoms. Clinical features of uterine fibroids. The incidence is at peak between 35 to 45 years of age. There is a tendency of delayed menopause. Symptoms. The majority of fibroid remain asymptomatic. They are discovered by the physician on the routine examination or in laparoscopy. The symptoms related to type of anatomy and size of the tumor. The size is more important than size. Menstrual abnormalities. Menorrhagia, a classic symptom of fibroid, means abnormal heavy bleeding. Excessive irregular menses and bleeding. Dysmenorrhea means pain during menstruation. Lower abdominal pain or pelvic pain. abdominal enlargement, pressure symptoms like constipation, dysuria, or even retention of urine, recurrent pregnancy loss, miscarriage, dyspareunia, painful sexual intercourse. There are some life-threatening complications which are very rarely seen, but they are as follow. Excessive bleeding leads to severe anemia. Infection leading to peritonitis or septicemia. Sarcoma. Thank you.
Shreyas, thank you, Manisha. Wasn't it excellent? You know, young students talking so flawlessly and with nice medical terms. I'm sure they're going to do very good in their final year exams and write good paper of gynec and obstetrics. Friends, now coming back to their nice little conversation with you, one has to understand that the sign and symptoms of fibroids grossly depend also upon the position of where the fibroid is. And as Shreyas said, the size and the location both is important, because if it's pressing against the bladder, obviously you're going to get some bladder symptoms, you're going to get difficulty in evacuation, you're going to get difficulty in micturation, which means painful, jalan ho jayegi wahan par. If it's behind, you may get constipation. If it's towards here, there can be difficulty in sexual intercourse. A big fibroid can also come in way of a proper pregnancy. So symptoms are immense. A bigger fibroid can also cause severe discomfort in the abdomen. So, I repeat, the sign and symptoms of fibroids are grossly dependent upon the size and the location of the fibroid. And hence, we can get all these sort of symptoms like bleeding to pain, to bleeding in between the cycles, which you call as menorrhagia, which is called metrorrhagia, menorrhagia. So all these symptoms are seen, and sometimes it can cause also depression. Of course, Shreyas also mentioned about the other life-threatening complications, which are rare, but a doctor and a patient should also know that these things can happen. Many a times the patient just comes, "Doctor Sahab, I'm just feeling heaviness. And doctors think it is dyspepsia, which means pet bigad gaya hai, kuch gas ho gaya hai, and all these things. But then a good clinician identifies that yes, it can be something more than that. Well, then we all know the patient goes for sonography. He sees that and sonography shows fibroids. Do you know the fibroid size can be from a coin to a watermelon? Yes. It can be a coin to a watermelon, such huge size of the fibroid can be seen. And then after the first USG, there is a panic, depending upon the lady's age, depending upon whether she wants to be fertile, or depending upon she already has children and now no need. And then the running around starts. Then the Googling around starts. Then the looking for nice lectures on our help library starts. And I tell you, help library offers really great amount of help to people. You see the likes and the views of help library, it's immense. I again applaud the efforts of the entire team of help to provide such quality information in all the faculties of medicine and alternate medicine to all the people over the globe with just a click. So kudos to the team help for doing it. And then patients go to a gynecologist, who of course advise them if required. They say that surgery is required. Okay, the fibroid is very big, you want to be a mom, or even if she is late 40s, where the fertility issue is not there anymore, but the symptoms are there, they are advised that surgery is to be done. Friends, I am nothing against surgery. As a curriculum and course in homeopathy, we have surgery for 1.5 years. We study as much as the MBBS and the surgeons do. But what we are taught is that surgery is advocated only when the A, B, C, D criteria are fulfilled. And if the symptomatically and the sign and symptom wise and the medical knowledge tells us that, well, this patient can be managed without surgery, and a few, you know, do's and don'ts, dietary changes, exercises and medicines, then I'm telling you here, if the fibroid is not too big, if the lady, okay, it has not to have a immediate fertility issue, okay, or if the bleeding is not too immense or the symptoms are not too immense, and if we can tide over the crisis for some time, homeopathy has a wonderful scope in the management of fibroids. The point to be noted here is that all patients with fibroids, with moderate and small size of fibroids, need not always go for surgery, and we can manage these people with our medications, and the surgeon's axe can be avoided. As I always say, in homeopathy, we do not have a set formula that this patient comes, give him estrogen, this patient comes, give him cybalium for migraine, or give him XYZ treatment for this. We have more than 100 drugs for every medical condition. And the reason being that homeopathy is highly individualistic. So when a lady comes to us for fibroids, we first take a detailed history, which may last for an hour or two even, and try to understand where the fibroid is, what are the symptoms, how much is the bleeding, when is the bleeding more, when is the pain more, when is the other symptoms coming up more, what dream she is getting, how is her mental state, and how is her mental state changed over the last 3-4 months when these symptoms have started. And taking into account, we prescribe something called as a constitutional medicine, which is the sort of a mainstay of homeopathic treatment. But we also have some specific drugs which take care of the symptoms. Friends, may I remind you again that the management of fibroid is not just one medicine management or one drug management where, you know, one constitutional medicine may take care of everything. It's not that way. Sometimes there's bleeding. You have to see the type of bleeding and give drugs like phosphorus or trillium pendulum or cinchona or ipecac, depending upon how the bleeding is. Sometimes if the menses are irregular, then we have to give some drug which takes care of the irregular menses. Sometimes there may be super bloating and we have to give drugs like carbo-veg or china or lycopodium or rafanus, and all these drugs come up. So it's a two-pronged treatment for fibroids which we advocate. First is the constitutional, and then as and when, and it does occur at some juncture, we have to give this medicine at some juncture. Some ladies feel so much of pain, severe pain, we have to give MAG-FOS, which is an important pain remedy. Some ladies bleed between the periods so much with clots, we have to give them drugs like Thalapsi Bursa Pestoris. So management of fibroid requires, on the part of a good homeopathic physician, knowledge of many drugs and the symptomatic treatment, the pathological and the physiological, physical prescriptions, and the constitutional treatment. Let us see some important drugs which we prescribe. Calcarea carb, the lady will be a fat, flabby lady. Are you aware, sir? When a person walks in our clinic, we can make out a general plan that this is a fat person, he is a stout person, he is so much of perspiration, the drug changes. He is a thin, slim person who is stoop-shouldered, the drug changes. So we homeopaths have to be so observant, you see, that the case taking begins as the patient walks inside. Many a times the case history begins in the CCTV camera, which we see when we are taking case inside, and the patients in the waiting room, we can see some patients are becoming restless. Some patients sit there and take the AC and close their eyes. Some people start writing the God's name, 1000 God's name in 2 hours. So from that also, good and bad is a different story. Everything is good, okay, the way you look at it. So our history taking starts right from the time the person enters the clinic, and you observe him when he is not observing you. Nowadays, college girls and guys, when they come, they keep on playing with their Android. They can't even be 10 minutes away from that. Tuk, 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 chal raha hai. Is it love or I don't know what is it, but fine. That's not too good, friends, and science is shown that being too close to mobile all the time also creates unhealthy state. So one should be away from it. One must read books, and that's the reason we have so many books here. So friends, fair, fat, flabby, overweight person, this calcarea carb person will first tell the person, ye AC band karo, bahut thandi lag raha hai. It's a very chilly person whom we are talking about. So this remedy comes for fibroids. Then we have this master remedy, which is a specific remedy. Thalapsi bursa pestoris. See, the menses appear at short intervals. The lady says that, Dr. Saab, I am feeling so tired. My menses got over some time back and again it's come up. As if one menses runs into another. And this causes so much of problem. As Shreya said, this can cause also anemia. And for anemia, then again we have different set of remedies. Ferrum metallicum, we can have alumina. All these remedies come. So again, I'm saying that you can't have one remedy for the management of fibroids in homeopathic parlance. There are multiple remedies coming up as per the symptoms which emerge. Severe cramping pains in the uterus. Menses large, clotted and dark blood. I say here that for a good homeopath to achieve good success, this drug is important, and this drug should be there in the kit which we provide for ladies as a very important female remedy. Thalapsi bursa pestoris. Third year question, my friends. Oh, fantastic. Another drug, Trillium pendulum. This is a bleeder. Trillium pendulum is a bleeding remedy where excessive bleeding with fainting spells, faints because of the excessive hemorrhage. Profuse menses every 2 weeks, lasting for a long, long, long time. This is also a good drug during climaxes. Climaxes is the period as the end of the menstruation. Menarche is a start at 13, 14. Climaxes is the end at 48, 49, 50, whatever time. This drug is also one good drug for the same. My friends, I must have seen a couple of hundreds of cases of fibroids. And you'll not believe here, let me share with you friends, because I am a very open prescriber. I share my successes and I share my failures. Fraxinus americans, mother tincture, has helped me immensely in my practice. And there may not be a single lady or very few ladies who may not have got this medicine from me when they come, because Fraxinus americana, mother tincture, we have powers, mother tincture, then 30 potency, 200, 1 mL. So mother tincture is sort of the crude drug, the basic drug. So mother tincture of Fraxinus americana can be taken. I prescribe 10 to 15 drops in the morning, in the evening, along with water, and the results are very, very encouraging. This has been used by many allopathists and Ayurvedic physicians also, because this drug has the power to reduce the size of the fibroids. The other symptoms along with this are the cramping, pain in the feet and excessive menstrual bleeding. A cousin of homeopathy is called as biochemic system. Well, it's a whole new system in its own way, but because the senior homeopaths discovered this, like Schusler, the indications, they come closer. So calcarea flor is one biochemic remedy which we prescribe in 3x potency or 6x potency, and we have seen great results. In fact, calcarea flor is one of the tumor remedies of homeopathy. You have tumor here, benign, is given. Many Calcutta physicians, when I used to work in Calcutta, they have given calcarea flor for advanced cancers also, because it has the power to shrink all the growths per se. So calcarea flor 3x can be given. Other remedies I have already mentioned. Now comes the question, that how should we have a follow-up of this patient? My understanding is very clear, and I'm a very rational homeopath. I never claim that I have treated cancers and I have treated all complicated cases, but I tell a patient that, look, for next 3 or 4 months I'm going to try my level best to help you out in your symptoms and help you out with the pathological changes and also changes to be seen on a repeat sonography. So what we do after medications, we repeat one sonography after 2 months, and if there is a change in size, it has regressed and no new additions have been made in the fibroids. We give a pat on our back and homeopathy that we are doing some good work and we have been able to save the patient from surgery, because any surgery, why should it be done? Just because the lady has two children and just because she is 45 plus doesn't mean that every lady with fibroids must have a hysterectomy. Sir, madam, I ask you a question. Just think 20 years back or 30 years back, were there so many incidences of hysterectomy? And why has hysterectomy suddenly increased nowadays? Is there a commercial reason? Or really there is some problem which is occurring? Whatever, I don't know, I leave it to you. My only point here is not to create controversy here, but to say here that yes, homeopathy has something good to offer in fibroids. And if the fibroid size is not too big, and if there is no fertility issue which has to be immediately to be taken, we can give a fair trial to homeopathy. And I tell you, my cases results have been encouraging. So many ladies who have come with fibroids, the bleeding abnormality and the pains, and this multi-pronged treatment has helped them. After 2 months, we repeat sonography, it shows less in size. After 4 months, there have been cases where these fibroids become so less that it becomes asymptomatic. You can jolly well forget it. And maybe a repeat sonography after every year just to see everything is going fine. A lady, 35, with two daughters, came to me, my patient of over 6 years, and she said, ki, Dr. Sahib, mane bo vadhare bleeding thai che, and clots also happening. So I suspected, because she had a parental, the mother had fibroid, even she was my patient. We examined her, investigated her, and her drug of choice for this lady was phosphorus based on the constitutional, and also the calcarea carp coming up sometimes, thalapsi bursa coming up sometimes. Within 1.5 months, the symptoms subsided. Within 2.5-3 months, the size of the fibroid became less. And after 4 months, you will be surprised that there was no fibroid left in the, it was an intramural fibroid, there was nothing left to show. And the symptoms also regressed in a big way. Another patient I know, female, 47, perimenopausal with fibroids. And perimenopausal lady, the bleeding becomes erratic anyways. It was thought to be menopausal, but then investigated, there was a fibroid sitting up there. Symptoms of urinary obstruction also coming up. Advised surgery immediately. Jaldi karo, karna padega, problem aa jayega, cancer ho jayega. Aise darao mat yaar sabko, darao mat. We medical people are not there to make people scared. We are made to comfort people. And surgery is always the last option after the medical line of treatment fails. This is what most of my great surgeons whom I know, whether Dr. Rodhan Shroff or Dr. K.V. Chaubal, the great orthopedic surgeon, says, Rahul, surgery, I used to run behind him, in Bhatia Hospital. Inka naam announce hua, I used to run behind them. Sikhna hai, bin guru gyan kahan se pao. And they used to say that surgery is the last option. And a good surgeon is a surgeon who knows when to touch and when not to touch. Waise log nahi rahe, no problem. Of course, there are a lot of good people also, lots and lots of good people, but and bad people are there everywhere, in our pathy also, everywhere. But what happens is that these, over commercial people, maybe they are spoiling the name of the pathy. One should not happen. In conclusion, friends, the management of fibroids should be done in a very rational manner. Homeopathy has definitely lots to offer. One lady, I was mentioning about that 47-year-old lady, she was advised surgery, and I said, no way, this is manageable. And the drug of choice was Sabina, given to her, along with Thuja Maja tincture, and Thalapsi Bursa pectoris sometimes, and also Fraxinus Americana Maja tincture. Within 2 months, she had a regression in all her symptoms. She felt better, the pain had vanished, the bloating was no more. Anyways, she was menopausal, so the cycle was erratic, but these excessive symptoms of bloating and something coming down, all these things went away. Well, so to conclude, I say here, that homeopathy does have something good to offer to the lady. We must take it in a practical way. And after 3 or 4 months, if God forbid, if it's not working, then well, a good surgeon must be requested to do the surgical expulsion of the fibroid. Thank you, friends. I hope you enjoyed the lecture, and I wish all the ladies a fantastic health. Ladies, make a family. Ladies, take care of the husband, of the in-laws, of the children. And I urge all the men not to, take the lady's symptom for granted. Because what happens is that, I'm sorry to say, many a times when the gents come home, the ladies are sort of complaining sometimes. It's not complaining, they are saying ki, I'm getting a headache, I'm getting fever, I'm not feeling well. And we men generally neglect it. Are haroj kya hai? So don't do that, please, gentlemen. We are gentlemen, so we must be more sensitive. And if these symptoms come up, we must see to it that we give a lot of love, tender care and affection for the ladies, because as you all know, ladies are more sensitive and ladies need more attention, and it's our duty as gentlemen to give them more love, care and attention. Thank you.